much more clean economy, cleaner environment, more green and sustainable country, environment, right? And the call is on all of us, really. It's not only on COFA, it's only on PASH. We all have a role to play in this. And I like what the Honorable Minister said. The Sankori call for proposal has been opened. Take advantage, apply for it. Let's see how we work together to achieve this together.
The climate is becoming a problem for all of us. We have a responsibility to protect this environment for our future generation. So we signal to the international community, first in New York, at last year General Assembly meeting, when His Excellency launched this EV policy, and secondly at COP in Dubai, as a follow-up to indicate to the world that Ghana is prepared to move to the area of trying to protect this environment. We did so because we had in mind that we could not do it alone. We did so because to signal to the international community that we need the support in terms of funding and also in terms of human capacity. Through innovation, through research. And I think the signal that we made to the international community is resonant to all of them that yet Ghana is prepared. So when I had an invite that I need to be part of this program, I said, thank God. Yet we have another opportunity to also let the people know that indeed we are committed in this area. If we look at our environment, transport sector contributes almost about 30 to 40% of emission in Ghana. So this sector is very, very important. So if you have a company who is prepared to help to reduce the decarbonization, to make sure that we decarbonize our environment, I think it's a liable thing and it's something that we need to support. What I would say is that we need technological transfer. We have the human capacity. Our youth are very intelligent. What they need to do is to train them. Yesterday, I had a meeting with the COFA people. I was happy to hear that with a staff strength of about 20 people, only 3 of them are non-Ghanaians. 17 are people that they've trained. So I told the gentleman that our youth are very intelligent. What they need to do is to train them. And I'm sure together we can all try to lead to employment creation. We can build the innovation that we need. And also it may also generate the technological transfer that we are looking for. People are afraid, and I think legitimately so, that yes, we are moving away from fossil fuel into this thing. What will be their fate, especially those people who may not, in quote, be too well educated, our fittest by the roadside. So I think that we need the private sector to join us, to come out with innovation, how we can also train them. Because most of them, the sort of skill that they have, the job that they've done over the years, what they need to do is to do a little bit of training for them. And I'm sure they will be able to close the gap. This fear will go away, and together we can build the future that we are looking for. So COFA is good. I've been told that the Sankori Fund, we are launching it today. I'm entreating Ghanaians, I'm entreating everybody here to put in the application. I think that we have the capacity to apply for this fund. And together it will help all of us to decarbonize the environment. Look, this global thing that we are talking about, people think that it's about 100 years to go. If I told you what is happening at our sea today, you will marvel. The sea is depositing a lot of sand on our shore. Of UK trying to partner a private sector to scale up our electric mobilization policy. We made two significant decisions last year to signal to the international community that Ghana was ready to be part of decarbonizing our environment. The climate is becoming a problem for all of us. We have a responsibility to protect this environment for our future generation. So we signal to the international community, first in New York at last year General Assembly meeting, when His Excellency launched this EV policy, and secondly at COP in Dubai as a follow-up to indicate to the world that Ghana is prepared to move to the area of trying to protect this environment. We did so because we had in mind that we could not do it alone. We did so because to signal to the international community that we need the support in terms of funding and also in terms of human capacity. Through innovation, through research. And I think the signal that we made to the international community is resonating to all of them that yet Ghana is prepared. So when I had an invite that I need to be part of this program, I said, thank God. Yet we have another opportunity to also let the people know that indeed we are committed in this area. If we look at our environment, transport sector contributes almost about 30 to 40% of emission in Ghana. So this sector is very, very important. So if you have a company who is prepared to help to reduce the decarbonization of our environment, I think it's a liable thing and it's something that we need to support. What I would say is that we need technological transfer. We have the human capacity. Our youth are very intelligent. What they need to do is to train them. Yesterday, I had a meeting with the COFA people. I was happy to hear that with a staff strength of about 20 people, only 3 of them are non-Ghanaians. 17 are people that they've trained. So I told the gentleman that our youth are very intelligent. What they need to do is to train them. And I'm sure together we can all try to lead to employment creation. We can build the innovation that we need. And also it may also generate the technological transfer that we are looking for. People are afraid, and I think legitimately so, that yes, we are moving away from fossil fuel into this thing. What will be their fate? Especially those people who may not, in quote, be too well educated, our fittest by the roadside. So I think that we need the private sector to join us, to come out with innovation, how we can also train them. Because most of them, the sort of skills that they have, the job that they've done over the years, what they need to do is to do a little bit of training for them. And I'm sure they will be able to close the gap. This fear will go away and together we can build the future that we are looking for. So COFA is good. I've been told that the Sankore Fund, we are launching it today. I'm entreating Ghanaians, I'm entreating everybody here to put in the application. I think that we have the capacity to apply for this fund. And together it will help all of us to decarbonize the environment. Look, this global thing that we are talking about, people think that it's about 100 years to go. If I told you what is happening at our sea today, you will marvel. The sea is depositing a lot of sand on our shore. And whatever structure that you put in terms of fishing infrastructure, in terms of port infrastructure, you have the issue of dredging becoming an issue for us. So the environment, we are facing a lot of challenges. I think that all of us, we need to contribute our quota to protect this environment for our people. So let's take advantage of this fund. Let's take advantage of this fund for the future research, and I'm sure together it will benefit all of us. UK and Ghana have had a very long-term relationship. They are our colonial masters. They trained us, and I'm sure what it is that they need to come to our aid, we all work together to make sure that we chart a common path. Thank you very much, and I hope that this tour will bring benefit to all of us. Thank you.
a much more clean economy, cleaner environment, more green and sustainable country, environment, right? And the call is on all of us, really. It's not only on COFA, it's only on PASH. We all have a role to play in this. And I like what the Honorable Minister said. The Sankori call for proposal has been opened. Take advantage, apply for it. Let's see how we work together to achieve this together.
Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and click on the bell for more updates.